I lost my fan.
In 3 seconds, I lost my fan. I took it down for 2 seconds to go get makeup wipes, and I lost my fan. Oh, Lord. Hi, guys. My name is Lacey. Speak Lips and Fat Hips, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's a long time coming, but I'm finally giving you guys a new palette series video. I feel like I just enunciated palette really intensely. Palette. Yes, today is going to be another installment of my palette series. And if you're new to my channel, the palette series is a series. The heat is starting to get to me. The palette series is a video series The palette series is a video series where I'm slowly showing you guys my eyeshadow palette collection little by little, segment by segment, because I have a huge eyeshadow palette collection and a lot of you guys want to see it, and I want to do it in this format where we're going theme by theme. And today's theme is the theme that you can find on my face. Today we're going to be talking about palettes with a pop of blue. Pops of blue are very on trend right now. They're very on point. They're very in, if you will, and for good reason. Pops of blue look really cool, and I'm not here to shit on pops of blue. I appreciate a palette with a pop of blue. They look, pops of blue, especially when paired with warm tones, but in general, just look like very, like you're trying really hard, and like you've put together a really like high fashion editorial eye look with minimal effort. Especially in the case of like what's specifically on trend right now, which is like the oranges with the blue. Because those are complementary colors, you're putting together a very striking eye look that maybe you might not have thought of before if those colors were not paired together for you. So I'm not here to shit on Pops of Blue today. I'm here to encourage you to go for the Pops of Blue, and I have quite a few palettes here. I really even had more than this in my collection with Pops of Blue, which goes to show you how overdone this concept probably is. I get it. But I have a lot of variety for you. I have, you know, different options. I have one throwback palette that maybe you have in your collection that you thought about. So we're going to go through it. I'm going to be showing you my picks for my favorite palettes with pops of blue. And yeah, if you haven't found a blue eyeshadow for you yet, maybe you will throughout this video. There's definitely palettes I've shown you guys before in this video, but I couldn't not show you this one specific palette. This is the Gimme Glow Cosmetics Quad Goals palette. I'm not sure what this exact palette is called. They have a couple quad goal palettes, and all they say is just give me glow quad goals. But I've shown this specific palette before, and I feel like this palette is 4 colors. It's very straight to the point. You're getting those warm tones, you're getting one matte blue. So this is perfect if you were very into that like Kylie Cosmetics blue lower lash line thing that happened last summer that people lost their minds over. This would be a good palette for that. But this blue is like the blue to end all blues. Holy shit, like their formula is so pigmented. And I don't want to go and swatch everything in this video, but like, holy shit. I know the first time I shared this palette on my channel, a lot of you guys were like, holy shit, I have to have it. And like I said, it's just very straight to the point. You get enough match, you only get one shimmer, you're going to get very similar eye looks every time, but if you're only looking to create one specific eye look, you don't want to buy like a huge, crazy pant, like, 10 plus pan eyeshadow palette, you already have warm tone palettes maybe, this could be a good one to just throw in your collection. Gimme Glow is not that cheap. They are a little bit more on the pricey side, but you're getting huge pans, so see the value in that, and which you will. I know that I will never hit pan on eyeshadow probably ever, given the size of my collection. If you're in the same way where it's like you don't care how big a pan is, you just care about the overall price, I can see maybe this not being the best option for you. But if you are someone who just wants maybe a couple new warm plus blue shades to add to your collection, this is small enough and enough of a bang that I feel like it's worth it to throw in your collection, if that makes sense. Because I mentioned it, I might as well talk about it. The Kylie Cosmetics Royal Peach palette. This is a controversial palette, arguably. This is the palette that made me want to try Kylie Cosmetics. I know in the past I've said that I'm never shopping from them again, and so far that is true. There has yet to be a release that has brought me back since the holidays. But I will say, Originally, when this came out, I was so on the peach trend last summer, and then Graveyard Girl did a video where she swatched this palette in comparison to the Too Faced Sweet Peach palette, and the second I saw this blue shade, I said, holy shit, I have to have it. It did smell like glue when I bought it. It doesn't smell now. It's fine. The brush is a piece of crap. I don't care about that. This blue is nice. This palette's good. Out of all the Kylie palettes that I've tried, I've given palettes away before. This one's nice. I like the metallics. I like the other shimmers. It's nothing crazy. It's not... This palette isn't mind-blowing, but it's nice. And it's definitely... Out of everything I've tried from Kylie Cosmetics, I'm not horribly impressed with her stuff. I don't think that her stuff is worth the price that she puts on it specifically. So if you're interested in this palette, and like I said, you liked the peach trend that happened last summer with the pop of blue, it's funny that it came back again this summer. This is good if you can get it on a sale, and I think that I have seen it on sale a couple times on her website. Don't expect the most pigmented shadows, don't expect the most mind-blowing shit ever. Expect mediocre with this palette, but nice. Does that make sense? This green, also side note, is really fucking nice. I like that green a lot. You're gonna get the same kind of look almost every time with this palette. It's one of those kind of things, because all of the tones are really very similar, minus the blue. If you're into peaches, though, and you haven't ridden off Kylie Cosmetics, give it a shot. I don't know. If you're looking for the kind of Kylie Cosmetics, I don't want to say quality, because I do think that this palette is better quality than Kylie Cosmetics, but you're looking for something like that, but with a much smaller price tag. This is one that I haven't talked about on my channel ever, and it's brand new. It's the Perception palette by ColourPop. It's Makeup by Shayla. Is it just Makeup Shayla? No, I swear to God, her YouTube name is Makeup by Shayla. Shayla x ColourPop collab. This palette isn't revolutionary in concept, but this really is like the on-trend warm tones with pops palette, and I feel like if you had this, it could very much be the only pop palette that you ever need in your collection. It has you covered with a pink, it has you covered with a green, and it has you covered with, most importantly, the point of this video, a blue. I really like ColourPop's eyeshadow formula, their pressed eyeshadow formula. I think they're so super pigmented. I can get away using their shadows without an eyeshadow primer, and they last all day for me. Their metallics are so super nice, and I just feel like for the price, you're getting nice packaging, you're getting a mirror, you're getting all these shadows. Even these shades pop out, so maybe if there's one or two you're not crazy about, you can swap it with maybe some other shades. You just can't beat it. This is so nice. And I saved this palette to talk about specifically for this video because really, of all the palettes I'm going to mention for this video, this is the one that I would recommend the most specifically for the price. And I think ColourPop palettes are kind of hit or miss lately, like concept-wise, color story-wise, just because they all tend to be the same. If you have one, you have them all. If you were looking to try one you haven't yet, this one is really nice. Like I said, is it the most revolutionary? No, but I think Shayla did a good job picking out colors that are cohesive and work together, and that you can get a nice eye look every time with this palette. If you are more of a neutral to cool tone lover, though, might I suggest the Lorac Pro 2 palette. The Lorac Pro palettes are like what I would consider classic staple palettes. Like, they're just good and classic, and a lot of people have them in their collection because they're reliable. I also, Lorac to me has a very specific formula in that they're very powdery and pigmented and creamy, and that's a hit or miss kind of thing. People either love that or hate that about Lorac. I love that about Lorac, and they have this gorgeous navy blue. I love this shade so much. I also love the purple and this green. This is a good palette. Like I said, if you're a more neutral to cool tone lover, this is a great palette for me to recommend to you. It has a whole row of mattes and a whole row of shimmers, which I love about Lorac Pro palettes. And the pans are tiny, but the thing with Lorac's formula is a little goes a hell of a long way. Like I said, they're very buttery, creamy, powdery, messy goodness shadows, if that makes sense. They're not the kind of stiff pigment that you would get in like a Viseart shadow or a Sugar Pill shadow. They're that kind of like creamy, has the potential to muddy together very easily pigmented shadow that can be tricky to work with, and less is definitely more with a formula like that. But these like practically blend themselves. They're so buttery, they like melt into your eyes. I really like this, and I know this comes with an eyeshadow primer. The Lorax eyeshadow primer is not bad. Not my favorite, but it's definitely not bad. And I feel like more and more lately you can find these on sale because, like I said, they're not new palettes. They've been around for a while, but not bad. Not bad at all. And this navy blue, I mean, that's a good navy blue. I had to throw this palette in here. This is the Urban Decay Gwen Stefani palette, which is a couple years old at this point. But I'm throwing it in this video to encourage you to dig it out of your collection if you also have it. This palette is also very neutral and arguably cool tone, and a lot of these shades are the same. But like I said, I wanted to throw it in here on the off chance that maybe you have this palette too and you've forgotten about it. Because it does have a really nice metallic blue in it. It's more on the dark side. It's not as warm as other blues that I'm probably going to be talking about in this video. But it's nice, and like I said, if you have it and you want that pop of blue effect, this could give you it. This is a palette that I actually really love. I feel like this is a very divisive palette. Like, people either love it or hate it. This was one of my first, like, I'm obsessed with it kind of high-end palettes. I don't know. I really like it. I like the packaging, too. I like the blush palette in this collection. Just a nice thought. It's a nice blue. I mean, it's okay. Just, if you have it, use it. Ooh, this palette though. We're jumping into like what I would recommend to you if you're like, Lacey, I want a really nice palette with a pop blue. What do you recommend? We're jumping into what I would recommend like very specifically now. First, I'm going to start with the Makeup Addiction Cosmetics Smoked Out palette. So this is more darker tones. But this palette is amazing if you like those darker tones. If you like smoky looks, oh, I can't say enough good things. The only thing is, you're only getting 3 mattes, and again, you're getting these very big pans, which is cool if you don't have a lot of makeup and you do go through your eyeshadow completely, but if you're someone like me, that could be a miss. But this blue is unreal. This blue metallic eyeshadow is fucking unreal. I love this palette. I travel with the Makeup Addiction palettes because they're kind of more on the sturdy side. They're so creamy and so pretty. I feel like I'm getting dirty in eyeshadow. They have one of those duochrome blue brown shades, but like their metallic formula is crazy creamy. They're the kind of metallics that are wet to the touch, therefore they're very high impact on the lid. This blue is everything. This blue compared with this matte red shade creates such an impactful look. It's stunning. It's absolutely stunning. I could not recommend this enough. I love Makeup Addiction Cosmetics. They're supposed to come up with a new palette this summer. I'm waiting for that release because I have yet to be disappointed. Their color stories tend to be a little confusing, I think, in some of their palettes. But this one I really recommend if you are like a darker, smoky eyeshadow lover, for sure. If you are an earth tone lover like myself, you gotta go with the Nubian 2 from Juvia's Place. You guys have seen me talk about this before. You've seen me talk about Juvia's Place before. But for good reason. They make such good eyeshadows. And again, like Makeup Addiction, their foils are very wet to the touch. Very pretty. I mentioned before that I was salty about missing the Kat Von D Nubian, or not the Nubian palette, the Kat Von D Serpentina palette. And then I was kind of researching it, and this is like almost an exact dupe for that palette. So I guess I can't be that sad. Look at these. Holy shit. I really can't say enough good things about Juvia's Place. Their mattes are very pigmented and easy to work with. Their metallics are even better and just so creamy and amazing. There's so much selection in Juvia's Place eyeshadows. And there's so many palettes with blues. But I wanted to pick this one specifically because I love earth tone palettes. You guys know that. And this one has that gorgeous blue that we're sticking with today in this theme. So maybe if the cool tones aren't for you, if the super warm tones aren't for you, this one could be for you. Again, pair it with this orange because the blue and the orange are complementary colors. You're going to get such an impactful, specific, like high fashion, artistic eye look. And it's going to be amazing. But this purple, I mean, come on. Oh, this palette, this color over here. Oh. Stop it. Get away from me. I love you too much. This next palette is almost like, it confuses me that I love this palette so much. And I've definitely talked about it before. Violet Voss, Nicole Concilio collab. This is one of my go-to work palettes because of, it's mostly neutral. But it is more on the warmer side of neutral for sure. You get a lot of variations of orange. So pretty much every look you come out with is going to be the same. Just keeping it real. But if you love warm tones, if you're a warm tone eyeshadow lover, which warm tones look good on like almost everybody, I have never seen anyone look bad in warm-toned eyeshadows. Like, there's a reason they're so popular. It's because they tend to be very flattering on most people and just universally gorgeous on most people. This palette is just really nice. I love Violet Voss's formula. I love their shadows. They're not the most affordable. I do wish that all of their palettes were kicked down like 10 bucks in price, because they're not the most mind-blowingly great palettes, but they're really good, if that makes sense. And the reason I love this palette specifically is because it has so many oranges, and it really makes this blue, but also this orange and this yellow, like, really pop. And just every look I've ever done with this palette comes out really good, so I had to throw it in there. For me, I wish this palette had a metallic red. I think a metallic red would go so well with all of these, like, super warm orangey matte shades. Also, definitely a couple of these could have maybe been kicked out for things with more variation, but this is just a really nice palette. I know that it's on sale all the time. You can definitely get it at a discount. And their metallic formula is really freaking good. Spoiler alert, I want to do a video in the future on if I think Natasha Denona metallic eyeshadows are worth it. The spoiler alert is her metallics that are supposed to be like legendary remind me a lot of Violet Voss. Take that as you will. Let me just show you, like, an orange next to the blue. Like, don't they just look so nice together? I don't know. I love this palette. It was one of my first Violet Voss palettes, and it really sold me on the brand. And I blame YouTube, maybe, for selling me on it. But, I don't know. I just really like that palette a lot. I'm never disappointed with an eye look with that palette. It blends so well. I feel like I've been talking about it for too long. The Big Mama. If you ever want to resist buying any future eyeshadow palette release, invest in the Jaclyn Hill palette, because I've been able to let go of a lot of palettes because it's dupable within this palette. Like, the Kylie Cosmetics Blue Honey palette is dupable within this. The new Urban Decay palette, the Beach one, duped within this. So it's just like, this has you covered. This has you covered. This is like, and I get it. This is a hype palette. It's Morphe. You're probably sick of seeing it. You're probably sick of hearing it. But trust me, like, I'm not a Jaclyn Hill fan. It's nothing personal. She's just not my cup of tea. I bought this because of the reviews behind it, and I agree with those reviews. This is a really good palette. It's probably the only warm tone with a pop palette you would ever need, because it's basically the idea of that Urban Decay palette that just came out, but expanded so you have a lot of it. Does that make sense? So basically, this whole corner is going to serve as your pop to all of these warm tones. But you do get, like, enough cool tones where this could be, like, a good variation. Like, you can get a lot of variety in this palette is what I'm trying to say. Not like the Violet Voss palette, where I feel like mostly all of your looks are going to turn out pretty similar every time. You can make a lot of different looks in this palette. If you're someone that travels with makeup, this is going to be perfect for you. I know that this is my traveling palette. Like, I, of course, wish it had a mirror, but beggars can't be choosers. It keeps the price down. I did get it before the palette was glossy and stain resistant, so now my palette is messy. Whatever, all my makeup's messy. But again, I have a lot of Morphe shadows. This is the best I've tried from Morphe. Their metallic formula is stupid good because, again, it has that, like, wet to the touch kind of feeling. And a couple of my shades are getting hard pan. Fuck. But, like, these shadows blend really nicely. I do think this palette was thought out very well. It's well-rounded. And like I said, you're pretty much going to have your bases covered. That matte shade swatched amazing. Holy shit, mattes don't normally swatch that good. The proof is in the pudding. This palette has hype for a reason. I feel like if you're really like, I want that warm with a pop trend, I don't have it in my collection, I invest in this. It's affordable enough. You can get it with discounts. If you don't like affiliate codes, cool. It's on Ulta. Ulta throws out 20% coupons every once in a while. You can definitely get this cheaper if the price is kind of off on you. I know it's kind of on the more expensive side for a Morphe palette. But, like, good shit. Like, I have no affiliation to Morphe or Jaclyn Hill. I'm saying this as someone who brutally loves eyeshadow. That's a good quality palette for the price, for sure. And then finally, if you're looking for just one palette, if you want my all-time number one pop of blue recommendation for you above all else, the Zuri Cosmetics Zuri palette is one of my all-time favorite palettes ever. ever, if I was going to redo the first palette series video where I pulled out all my favorite eyeshadow palettes, having had this now for a little bit, this would be in that video for sure. I brutally love this palette so much that I want to cry. And definitely, like, this is dupable within the other palettes I've showed you tonight, but there's something just so special about this palette. This is the palette that I'm wearing on my eyes today. First of all, this packaging is amazing. Their packaging is inspired by African prints, and just like, this is so gorgeous, this palette. Just like physically, aesthetically on the outside. It's that lightweight cardboard that I love. It has a mirror, which I love, but these colors are so beautiful. They're so warm. This blue is the best blue eyeshadow ever. This orange, these are so creamy. These are so creamy, pigmented, wet feeling mattes and shimmers. Whew, if pigment scares you, stay away from this. But if you are like, give me that pigment, whew. It's an indie brand from the UK. If you're in the US like me, there is going to be a conversion rate. It is going to be a little pricey to get it to you. But they've had a lot of 20% coupons, so I'm sure you can get it at a discount if you follow their Instagram. This is so nice. This is so nice. I've never been disappointed with an eye look I've ever created with this. My fingers are so super dirty from all the other eyeshadow. Their stuff is so nice. This is the only palette from the brand so far. They're brand spanking new, and I can't wait to see what else they come out with. These are just like, whew, whew, oh my god. You get these like berry tones, you get the super orangey tones, you get a purple. It's like, I'm so impressed with this palette. I feel like I'm just like a babbling idiot at this point. But these are just so nice, so blendable, so pigmented, so good, so well thought out. I love this palette so much. This is my number one pick. It's my number one pick. If you want one good palette, the Pop of Blue. Forget that Kim Kardashian palette. Forget their new Urban Decay palette. Forget any other palette I talked about in this video. This is such a good palette. This is so good. I would highly recommend it. I just, this purple, this orange, this mac and cheese shade. They're so nice. They're so nice. This is going to work on so many skin tones. It's so pigmented. It's so, whew, I'm repeating myself. It's just such a high quality, nice palette. I'm so impressed. I really took a jump ordering this palette because I saw it. I've never heard anything about the brand. I've never seen a review. I just saw it and didn't even think. I bought it and I'm so glad I did because it's so, so nice. Oh my god. Ah. Look at this makeup wipe. Doesn't it look like art? Now that I've swatched it all. Like, it looks like a Jackson Pollock. No, no it doesn't. I'm just losing my mind because it's late and it's hot out. Whew. It's getting hot. I filmed a couple videos tonight on these lights and I need to stop because I'm getting tired and my butt hurts. That being said, another palette series video concluded. What palette series video do you want from me next? Is there a specific color you want me to focus on? A specific brand you want me to focus on? A specific trend in the same kind of breath as these pops of blue kinds of things? Let me know down below what kind of video you would like to see next talking about eyeshadow. But yeah, let me know your favorite palette with a pop of blue. I know pops of color annoy people. I know, like, the pop effect, you cover that up and the rest of the palette's boring, blah, blah, blah. But I hope I offered you enough variety that maybe, like, if you're not looking for another warm tone palette, there were cool tone options for you and, like, blah, blah, blah. You know what I mean? I hope you saw that there are other options for pops of blue out there besides just, like, every single orangey tone warm tone palette with a pop of blue. I don't know. Hit like and subscribe if you like this video, if you like me, if you like this content, blah, blah, blah. you know how YouTube works. I don't have to explain it to you. Follow me on Instagram if you have not already because I'm more active on Instagram than I am on YouTube. I'm trying to get better at it. And I post on Instagram, like, commentary on new makeup releases, things I'm buying, things I'm thinking about buying, blah, blah, blah. So if you like this kind of talks about, like, what makeup I would recommend or, like, what I feel about makeup, definitely go to Instagram because that's where you're going to get it all the time. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Hit like, subscribe, chat with me down below, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys!